I think I tested this new 5-star legendary gem Void Spark enough, so now it's time for a review. I was lucky to get 5 out of 5-star Void Spark drop from a tank race run, and upgraded to rank 6, and I've been playing with it for a couple of days now. First of all, I will say that this is a really good gem in general, but it's not a must-have gem for everyone. I will explain why, but first, I want to go over the upgrades you get when you rank it up. So at rank 1, gem description says dealing damage conjures a Void Spark for 6 seconds. While the Void Spark is active, dealing damage has 30% chance to unleash lightning that chains up to 8 enemies, dealing 45% base damage plus 446 to each enemy. The important part here is the base damage percentage. And at rank 2, base damage goes up by 10% and it becomes 55% base damage. At rank 3, it gives you the first rank of attack speed buff, which is 4%. And at rank 4, base damage goes up by 10% once again, and it becomes 65% base damage. If you are thinking about getting this gem, I think you should upgrade it to at least rank 4, otherwise the damage is not going to be that significant. At rank 5, attack speed goes up by 4% and it becomes 8% attack speed buff. And at rank 6, you get one more base damage increase, but this time it goes up by 15% and it becomes 80% base damage. And like I said, I've been using this gem at rank 6, which is quite good at this rank. Of course, if you have resources to upgrade this even further, that's better. At rank 7, attack speed goes up by another 4% and it becomes 12% attack speed buff. And at rank 8, base damage goes up by another 15% and it becomes 95% base damage. At rank 9, attack speed goes up by 4% for the last time and it becomes 16% attack speed buff. And finally, at rank 10, base damage goes up by 15% and it becomes 110% base damage, and that's the final form of this gem. Let's continue this review like a Q&A, I think that should be better. So first question is, how does this gem work? It's quite simple actually. When you deal damage, it gets activated and it stays active for 6 seconds. You can increase the duration with beneficial effects duration buffs, so 2-piece Urge, another beneficial effects duration buffs you get from legendary items and reforge bonuses increases the duration of this gem, which is perfect. But the attack speed buff you get from the gem doesn't activate 4-piece Urge effect or Battle Top, so keep that in mind. Alright, you dealt your damage and now Void Spark is active. Then what? This gem can unleash one lightning strike for each second and it doesn't work by itself. You need to keep hitting your target to make it work, but it's not an issue because any type of damage triggers the lightning strikes. For example, if you hit your target once and leave a continual damage effect, those hits will keep it working. Let me show you that with a real example. As you can see, if I hit the dummy once, the gem will be activated, and even though I am not hitting anymore, lightning strikes still come out. That's because I leave a burn and poison effect on the target, but if I remove those effects, it will require me actually to deal damage again. I guess it's not that complicated, but still wanted to explain it, and that's how this gem works. Now let's move on to the next question. Which classes should use this gem? I think it's more about the build you use than the class itself. I will add some gameplay footage so you will be able to see how much damage it deals by itself, but I think the real good thing about this gem is how it can spread your dot effects around. I think it will be easier to explain it with an example. Now let's say you are playing as a necromancer, and let's say you have the Neve 2-star Viper's Bite or 1-star Everlasting Torment. You deal damage to one enemy on the idle and Void Spark unleash that lightning strike. Now that lightning is going to touch everyone around that one guy. And that lightning strike can spread your Viper's Bite or Everlasting Torment dots. Now that means with only one hit, you will apply your dot damages to almost everyone nearby. That way you can activate your 6 pieces of Banquet set effect on everyone right away. That's just one example. Now let's say you are playing as a Blood Knight. I am assuming you have Viper's Bite, Everlasting Torment or Seeping Pile, or all of them together. Now you are running around while using your Siphon Blood, right? This means you will trigger Void Spark and everyone is going to get hit by that. But Blood Knight doesn't really use Banquet set, how is it going to help? Well, most of the time, they use Mountebank or the Grace set. It doesn't really help with Mountebank, but if you are using the Grace set, spreading your dots means it will be easier to trigger 4-piece effect on the enemies. So basically, this gem is a really good way to spread your dot damages, and if you have a build that works around dots, then this gem is going to be good for you with any class you play. Alright, but you might not have a build that revolves around dot damages. Should you still get this gem? Well, that's a question you should answer by yourself. For example, I'm using it with my Crusader and I'm loving it so far, since the damage of the gem get boosted with my banner too. I think this leads to our last question. How much damage does Void Spark deal? Well, now you see some gameplay, I will try to slow it down so we can see the damages, but don't forget that I have around 27k damage, but it should give you some idea. Usually it hits between 5 and 15k, but when it crits, it can go up to 30, 35k with each strike. So you shouldn't expect a crazy amount of damage from this gem, but sometimes it gets you kills by itself. For example, I might get stuck in a CC chain, but my Void Spark keeps hitting people and it kills people. I saw that happen a couple of times, but it's not that often. So in conclusion, I really enjoy using this gem. I think it has a cool animation, which might be important for some people. It has a pretty good range, so in Battlegrounds, even if you are playing with a range class, you shouldn't have any problems. Damage-wise, it's not that high, but it does add up to your total damage output, so it's fine. And it's a perfect gem to use for builds with Grace and Banquet set items. And I explained this in detail on the second question. I think that's all I can say about this gem for now. I hope you find this helpful. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments and take care.